Children, we go ahead to our next topic, agricultural development. Now, as I had told you earlier, that in India, 2/3 of our population are dependent on agriculture, and in the world, it is 50%. So, efforts must be made to develop agriculture. So, what is agricultural development? It is the efforts to increase farm production in order to meet the growing demands of the increasing population, which is known as agricultural development. We need to develop it properly so that we can get more and more crops to feed the population of the countries all over the world. And how can we do it? Here are some of the suggestions. Increase the cropped area. We have more area where we can grow crops instead of having concrete buildings coming up there. So more area is required to grow crop. Increasing the number of crops that are to be grown. Not only one crop in one field, we can grow 2-3 crops in the same field. And how will we do that? By improving irrigation facilities, using fertilizers, using high yielding variety seeds. They are also called as HYV seeds. That means the seeds are so good that with one stem you can get lots and lots of fruits and grains on it. And mechanization of agriculture. That means everything manually, it doesn't work. We need to use more and more of machines. And if we use this, what is the advantage we will get? We will get food security will be ensured to all. Now, what is food security? When all the people in the country have sufficient, safe and nutritious food to eat so that they can lead a healthy and an active life. Every person in all over the world will get food. That is not only food to eat, but sufficient and safe and nutritious food to eat at an affordable price. So we need to develop agriculture, and you can see these are the ways where in which we can improve agricultural production. Children, we come to the last point of our chapter, which is a comparative study between a farm in India and a farm in US. Now let us learn about a farm in India. Now the farms in India are usually small in size, and they are usually 1.5 hectares. They are small land holdings. Now what are small land holdings? Let me explain to you. This is because of the inheritance law that is applied in our country. For example, a farmer named Ramu has 4 sons, and after his death the land then gets divided into 4 parts. That means each son will get 25 acres of land. So what happens? The land then becomes smaller and smaller with the generations, and these small lands are not very productive. So you can at least go only 1 or 2 crops mainly in these small lands. So they are not productive and not economical also. So this is the major factor in India. Because of our inheritance law, farmers have small land holdings. Now, what are the other things that are there in India? We will see we use subsistence farming. That means, what is subsistence farming? We are using primitive tools, and the farmer is growing mainly crops for his family needs, and whatever remains, he sells it in the market. So, and a lot of labor is required, and all the household people of his house get involved into this farming. And mainly it is done with primitive tools like tilling, sowing, harvesting. They are done with primitive methods of farming. And there is lack of storage facilities also. So the grains perish if they can't keep it for long. So the farmer has to sell it in the market and get a price. He cannot keep it for a longer time and wait for the correct price to be sold to earn profit. He has to quickly sell it because there are very less storage facilities in our country. Okay, so and most of the time he takes advice of his friends, elders and some government officials. He is not aware of the latest technologies of growing his crops so that he can get more produce from his land. So these are the points of the farms in India. Now in comparison, we will look at the farms in USA. Children, children, the farms in USA are very large, and a large variety of crops are grown in these farms, like wheat, corn, oats, barley, rye, oil seeds, all kinds of crops are grown because the farm size is large. They have large land holdings, and the average size of a farm is normally 250 hectares. It is a vast land holding. And they do commercial farming. In India we used to do subsistence farming, but here farming is mainly for commercial purpose, that means to earn profits. And they use modern machines. When the farm is large, it's not very difficult to have labor, so they use modern machines like seed drillers, harvesters, combine threshers, so less labor is required. And they have modern storage facilities, so the farmer can store his grains and wait for the correct price. Not like in India, where he cannot wait for the correct price because the crops will perish. He can't store it anywhere. And here in USA, the farmer takes scientific guidance because his computer is linked to the satellite, so he gets the latest information about how to go about increasing farm production. Okay, so in India, the farmer works like a peasant. And in USA, the farmer works like a businessman. So this is the comparison between a farm in India and a farm in USA.